How was the process for applying to Oxford?
Very hard.
Was it difficult?
It was not easy.
It's very competitive, but I have nightmares thinking about it still.
I'm very busy socially, so.
I love sleeping.
Lo más complicado de venir aquí es.
¿Qué tal? Soy Alex Pascual, biotecnólogo e investigador en la Universidad de Cambridge y hoy he venido a Oxford a preguntar a estudiantes de esta ciudad sobre cómo entraron en la Universidad de Oxford. Así que si te gusta este vídeo, házmelo saber en los comentarios porque habrá parte 2, pero vamos con el vídeo.
Hi, my name is Ananya. I'm a fourth year medical student at Worcester College in Oxford.
Hi, my name is Nicholas. I'm a third year chemistry student at Balliol College, Oxford.
Hi, my name is Scarlett and I'm studying medicine at Oriel College at Oxford.
Mi nombre es Ignacio, soy argentina, tengo 28 años y soy estudiante de doctorado.
Hi, I'm Nora. I study French and Russian at Oxford.
Hello, I'm Mike and I'm a third year engineering student at Oxford.
Hello, my name is Dee and I'm a C student in Modern South Asian Studies in Oxford.
Ethan, I'm studying at Moscow College.
And we're out here on this beautiful sunny Oxford day.
¿Qué te gustaría hacer en el futuro?
In the future, I'd like to work in civil service or something like that.
Journalism.
After graduation, I want to be a scholar focusing on the political economy of South Asia.
My dream in future is to become a pediatrician.
At the minute, a doctor, so I don't know what type yet. We have not started our clinical placement yet, but after that, maybe I'll know what specialty. But yeah, a doctor at the minute.
Definitivamente, una opción que contemplo mucho es hacer un postdoctorado una vez termine mi doctorado acá, porque realmente es una ciudad muy linda que ofrece mucho, tanto a nivel la ciudad de lo que uno puede disfrutar, como la gente de todo el mundo y todas las culturas que uno puede conocer. Es realmente muy interesante.
How did you get into Oxford?
I got into Oxford by doing a process of interviews. I did 4 interviews at 2 different colleges and then also by doing some other research which I included in my personal statement and submitted to the university.
I applied as most other people would through UCAS. I did admissions tests and an interview after submitting all the documents and finally got the offer.
I did quite well on my admissions test. I had 3 interviews, some of which were better than others. And yeah, it worked out in the end, I guess.
I got into Oxford by working really hard, reading a lot, doing a lot of essay competitions. That was my big thing. It's a unique experience for PhD because you have to prove that you're good at all 3 things, or at least capable of being good at all 3 things. So you want to be writing a lot, but like, you want to be engaging with current affairs, thinking about developing opinions on things, maybe engaging with some campaigns if that's what interests you. Just evidence your love for the subject in tangible things and write them down in your personal statement, then you'll be fine.
I think it was just a lot of reading around the subject. So I used to read a lot of like journals and then watch TED Talks and that kind of thing. And then in interview, you just have to speak passionately about any topic. And I think that's how you get in. Just be passionate about your subject of interest and speak about something you can talk about. And then, yeah, it just becomes like a discussion. And as long as you are interested in it and they can see you're interested, then.
I applied through UCAS, put Oxford as my first choice. I did the A-levels, chemistry, biology, mathematics, physics and Greek, and I did quite well, thank God, and here I am today studying chemistry.
Previously I did my undergraduate study in China and I'm interested in the political economy of South Asian countries, so that's why I've applied for here and continuing my study here.
Bueno, yo estoy acá a partir de una colaboración que mi grupo de investigación tiene con un grupo de la Universidad de Oxford.
I was pretty rigorous. I started preparing early in the summer. I started reading textbooks for physics and engineering and doing more and more maths and physics problems as I was preparing for the admissions tests. After submitting my personal statement and kind of ensuring my predicted grades were up to scratch, I kind of heavily focused on doing past papers for the admissions tests. And after getting my interview invite following the admissions tests, I focused on trying to secure some mock interviews with people who have previously studied at Oxford or Cambridge, just to get a bit of experience, you know, talking to professors and explaining yourself and your decision-making process. And yeah, completed my interviews online early in December and got my offer in January.
They asked me mostly about my personal statement, which had a whole library of books on it, which took sort of most of year 12 summer. And then to the admissions test, I did every past paper that was online. And for Russian, because I started Russian from scratch, they test you on a made-up language, which is an experience.
I spoke to my careers counselor. I arranged, you know, to have a few meetings with her. Went through the whole UCAS process, writing a personal statement. But for the most part, it was just about making sure I enjoyed my subject and doing the best I could in my exams.
Do you think it was difficult to get into Oxford?
It was not easy as a process. Kind of, it required a lot of time and effort, and obviously combining that with the rigorous school timetable, you know, a lot of lessons for and stuff like that. It was difficult to manage the time and ensure, but overall, I think if you have the motivation for it and if you kind of set it as your goal, I think it should work well.
Yes, actually, it is a little bit difficult. You know, it is very competitive for applicants to get here.
The French poem was gibberish and I have nightmares thinking about it still. But generally, they were quite friendly. So it wasn't the worst experience.
How was the process for applying to Oxford?
Very hard. Well, not very hard, very long. Very hard if you don't really love your subject. If you do love your subject, then you'll be okay. The big hurdle for me was the admissions test, because it's difficult for PP and it's not something that I'm naturally good at. So I had to train quite a lot for that.
What do you think you have in your CV that made you possible to come into Oxford?
Oh, that's a good one.
I think it's really important to show your passion in your CV, so I just included a lot of things I like to do outside of the subject that's still related to it. So different research projects I'd done in the past, just things that I found interesting. I included all my passions and specific areas of interest within my subject areas.
My grades were good, to be fair. My school grades were really good. But also, I did a lot of extra stuff, so I wrote a lot for journals and stuff that I was interested in within politics and within philosophy. And putting that effort in outside of your studies is very important.
Just an interest in my subject, I think. I think that's all they're looking for, really. Like I say, I had a personal statement that was full of French books, French film, I think they're not looking for a super well-rounded person, they are, but just someone that is really, really interested in their subjects.
En mi currículum lo más importante es que en su momento pude entrar a un muy buen laboratorio en Argentina y ese lugar fue el que me abrió las puertas a colaborar con grupos de investigación de acá. ¿Qué tiene mi currículum en particular? No sé, yo la verdad que me he esforzado durante mi carrera académica, estudiando, me he esforzado para hacer lo mejor posible y obviamente que en algún punto de las posibilidades que uno tenga dependen a nivel académico o qué desempeño uno tenga. Y bueno, en ese sentido yo traté de hacer las cosas lo mejor posible y bueno, y eso me ha abierto algunas puertas, sí, seguramente.
My CV, if I'm being honest, I think I did really well in my admissions test. I think that's probably what helped me the most. And then maybe the interview after that, but yeah, I think it was doing well in the admissions test that helped me get my place.
I think I had pretty good overall experience and awareness of what my subject entails. So I, throughout my school time, I did a few engineering-related projects and kind of inside programs related to engineering and science in general. And kind of that showed that my decision to take engineering was pretty well informed, and that was something I actually wanted to do, rather than just picking engineering out of the blue for no reason.
I think it is my multilingual ability. I can speak about five languages, which is highly relevant to the region and countries I will research on.
Other than my grades, I think definitely just the love of science and my love for chemistry. I think I've always known that I wanted to be a chemistry student, and the fact that that was the case seeped into, let's say, my interview process and into my personal statement. So I just made that as evident as I could.
Todos tienen en común que comparten que el factor número uno en importancia para ser admitido en este tipo de universidades no son las notas. Y yo pienso totalmente lo mismo en cuanto a mi experiencia para entrar en la Universidad de Cambridge. Por supuesto que el rendimiento académico, las notas, es un factor importante y que muchas veces se da por hecho que todo el mundo que viene a estas universidades lo tiene, pero no es ni de coña el más importante. Lo más importante es dejar pasión en lo que haces, que te gusta lo que haces, que realmente tienes una fuerza que te mueve por dentro para realizarlo y que has estado involucrado, por ejemplo, en otras actividades previamente extracurriculares que te han permitido demostrar esa proactividad que tienes, esas ganas, ese conocimiento que lo has podido poner en práctica. Así que Esto yo diría que sería el main takeaway del vídeo, lo más importante que os tenéis que llevar. Y debido a esto, la semana que viene, el próximo domingo, voy a subir un vídeo sobre mi currículum, el currículum que yo utilicé para entrar en la Universidad de Cambridge. Os contaré qué factores deberéis tener en cuenta, qué cosas podéis realizar a la hora de preparar vuestro currículum y qué actividades o qué podéis hacer desde ya para empezar a potenciar, a optimizar vuestro currículum para que seáis unos candidatos más interesantes de cara a los reclutadores o a los posteriores jefes que vais a tener o la persona que revise vuestro currículum para admitiros en universidades de gran prestigio, por ejemplo, o empresas o lo que sea, o qué puntos tenéis que tener en consideración para desarrollar vuestro perfil, para desarrollar vuestra excelencia y para crear vuestro currículum. Así que si veis este vídeo más tarde, una vez ya haya estado subido el otro, lo dejaré en la primera línea de la descripción. Estad muy pendientes, la semana que viene, próximo domingo, tendréis este vídeo en el canal. Ya con esto me despido. Un abrazo.